Hachette Audio presents Conspirituality, How New Age Conspiracy Theories Became a Health Threat. Written by Derek Beres, Matthew Remski, and Julian Walker. Read by me, Matthew Remski. Derek would like to thank his parents for never refusing to buy him books, which opened and continue to open his mind to the world beyond his body on a daily basis. And to his wife, Callan, for challenging, supporting, and loving him at every step. I'm Matthew, would like to dedicate this effort to my late friend and teacher, Luciano Jacobelli, artist, sinner, mystic. And to my partner, Alex, for her constant support, lucid feedback, and empathetic eye. And to my two young sons, that they inherit a world enchanted by emotional honesty and mutual aid. Julian extends immeasurable gratitude and appreciation to his family and friends, you know who you are, for their loyalty, empathy, and willingness to deal with an often too passionate contrarianism. He also holds dear the memory of his English teacher, Mr. Wandervant, as brave and kind a model of authentic inquiry as a schoolboy could have had. Thanks to the thinkers who have preceded us in the task of seeing New Age and wellness cultures clearly. Thank you to the healthcare professionals, disinformation researchers, and anti-extremism activists who gave us ground to stand on during the pandemic. We thank our podcast guests who helped stretch our brains to meet a wicked problem. And we thank our listeners for stretching our empathy with their many stories of sorrow and recovery. Prologue, March 2020. A friend of a friend is suddenly posting on Facebook several times a day. The mood is a strange blend of terror, belligerence, and sanctimony. She isn't scared of a little virus like COVID. Fear of the virus is more dangerous than the virus itself, she says. But new 5G cell towers, these were destroying our collective immune system. She questions the accuracy of PCR tests and then suggests they are actually causing the infections. One of her posts links to an article on a dodgy-looking alt-health site. You click through, but then bounce when you see links in the margins to articles about vaccines and autism and cilantro curing cancer. The comments in her feed are a dogpile of agitated folks overusing phrases that ping-pong between ominous and ecstatic. The agenda of powers that be, and everything is unfolding according to source. Who is this person? She led classes at your local yoga studio? You actually like her. Her classes were helpful during that rough patch in your life. She talked about loving your body and making peace with what is. Her voice was soothing. She was persuasive when she criticized conventional doctors for not connecting physical health to emotional health. While your family doctor didn't ask you a single question before writing you a script for Ambien, this yoga teacher connected you with an herbalist who did acupuncture. You went to two appointments, and they were great. You discussed your dreams while he stuck needles in your back. He talked about chamomile tea and valerian root tinctures, about how deep breathing resets your nervous system. Now, her studio is shuttered by COVID-19 lockdown. Your friendly yoga teacher seems to have ditched her own breathing exercises in the scramble to keep business flowing. She's posting at all hours. It's hard to know when she sleeps. She intersperses her red alerts with live stream yoga classes. There's always a Venmo link in the top comment. She waves sage around in front of her webcam and asks why the hell yoga isn't considered an essential service since there was nothing better for the immune system. The doctors aren't telling us that, she complains with a knowing smile before stretching into a downward dog. Speaking of essential services, she half jokes. essential oils were helping to keep her calm and balanced. DM her for details. Thieves' oil is an amazing antiseptic, by the way. One dude who shows up on every thread had recently left an office job to become an empowered men's life coach. He can't contain his contempt for people who are living in fear. CrossFitters lament being locked out of their boxes and share shrill articles about vitamin D and kimchi while claiming face masks are petri dishes for bacteria. Another regular is a doula who writes a mommy blog. She shares a paranoid post claiming that toddlers were all terrified of adults in masks. They were forgetting who their mothers were. And that herbalist the yoga teacher referred you to? There he is, proudly declaring he doesn't believe in germ theory. Yes, the same guy who stuck needles in your back. New German medicine is now his thing. Viruses are essential to our evolution, he announces. Join me on Telegram for more of the truth they don't want you to hear. The ominous mood is periodically relieved by posts from holistic healers who want to reassure everyone that everything is going according to plan. All the fear and uncertainty, just natural responses to a transformational time. A new phrase starts popping up. The Great Awakening. Within a few months, the ideas and memes are replicating and mutating as quickly as COVID-19 itself, infecting mutual friends, even showing up in your DMs. Make sure to watch this before they take it down, followed by a YouTube link to a homemade video with a weird voiceover and tons of graphics with statistics about something. You can't tell for sure because the uploader never linked to sources. More DMs. Coming from randos, they're strange. From in-real-life friends, the messages feel claustrophobic, and coming from family members, they're downright distressing. Mom, why are you sharing this with me? And just when you think it can't get any more tense or weird, it becomes clear that many of these posters are either promoting or getting drawn into uncharacteristic political invective. Worse, all of it is trending hard right-wing, just as the 2020 election campaign is ramping up. Someone you know to be gaga about organic food and ayahuasca posts a sermon from an angel channeler who had a vision that Trump was a light worker. A guy who leads chakra workshops for men and who once campaigned for Bernie Sanders is posting about Joe Biden being in the pocket of the Chinese. The timeline is chaotic, but cryptic hashtags keep it strung together. Hashtag save the children. Hashtag trust the plan. Hashtag enjoy the show. Hashtag WWG1WGA. It's chilling because you've heard these terms in a news report about QAnon, an online conspiracy theory that was melting brains and ruining families. Saving the children referred to the belief among Anons that elites around the world existed to perpetuate child sex trafficking. The show pointed to their belief that their invisible prophet, Q, was battling said elites in lockstep with Donald Trump, according to The Plan. Victory was a foregone conclusion. The weird string of letters was for the rally cry, "Where we go one, we go all," which they believed had been embossed on the bell of a sailboat owned by John F. Kennedy, who for some represented the last sitting president to challenge the American political orthodoxy. Other Anons came to believe he would return from the dead. Your yoga teacher starts looking more underslept on her stream, twitchier. She starts featuring some guy, probably dating him, who sells supplements and leads seminars on Bitcoin. They publish a couple's live stream titled, "Nothing Can Stop What Is Coming." What happened to these people? Most of whom you knew to be educated, well-meaning, politically liberal, or at least moderate, and generally kind? How, with all their talk about healing and oneness, had they fallen into a rabbit hole of right-wing paranoia scented with New Age candles? Where would it all lead? Introduction. If you've chosen this audiobook, there's a good chance that the landscape of our prologue feels familiar. In early March 2020, a lot of us noticed our social media feeds starting to prickle with uneasy questions. Is this virus thing serious? Should we be canceling that trip? Infection rates of something called COVID-19 were spiking somewhere. There were X and Y axis graphs to prove it. The upward line looked like a hockey stick. By mid-month, the clues and whispers crystallized in a world-stopping declaration from the World Health Organization. The NBA canceled its season as though turning off a light. Schools shuttered and church services were bumped to Zoom. Restaurants closed and the mail ground to a halt. The big box stores scrambled to put spacing stickers in the checkout lines. There was a weird run on toilet paper. Did you have enough flour at home? Alcohol wipes? What exactly were you supposed to wipe down anyway? What would the children do, and what would you do with them at home all day? By April, the challenge became balancing doom scrolling with the search for reliable info on what R-naught meant. We learned about flattening the curve and how to wash our hands long enough to sing happy birthday twice. Crafters started making masks at home from fabric ends with pockets for coffee filters. Facebook groups formed to collate the most helpful information about keeping safe or to organize grocery runs for shut-ins. But soon, among the images of hospital chaos in Italy and cruise ships docked like floating leprechauns.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.